Dude, I know I'm like 8 years late to this, something like that, but Sword Art Online is really f***ing good, dude. Holy sh**. I've always watched shonen anime since I've gotten into anime the past couple years. Like, I've seen Naruto, My Hero, Food Wars, stuff like that. But I've never really had a serious anime, you know what I mean? And Sword Art Online, good god, it was so good. Holy crap, man. It was so cool. Sword Art Online, it's this great anime about people essentially trapped in a video game. It's a lot like Spy Kids 3, Game Over. They could probably sue on basis of that, but we'll just let that slide. Like, I've heard that plot a million times, you know, Spy Kids. But for some reason in this anime, the stakes feel so high because the game is really hard. A lot of people die in the game. There's 10,000 people that start, and then by the end of season one, there's only 6,000 people that survived. So that means 4,000 people died. And you really feel that because every single fight, you know that people could die. The main character, Kirito, he's like this super strong dude. He meets this girl, Asuna. Like, they sort of get together and they're like partners and buddies after a while. But for a while, it's just Kirito just exploring this massive world that looks super cool. It's super interesting. And he meets all these characters and you're just like, I really got into the world when I was watching this. I just wish that season one was longer, honestly. There's just so many different concepts, just cool ideas that are in the show, and I was like, my god. A buddy of mine told me about this. He said, when I saw Sword Art Online, it really changed how I saw anime, because this is what was possible. This is what anime could be. This is what anime could be. What does that mean? Now I get it. This is what anime could be. Intense, character-driven. Like, a lot of the progress that happens in Sword Art Online is just purely based on the characters leveling up or like getting something back that they lost or something like that. And they go through a lot of different factions and just ideas too. And it really feels like a cohesive world with a lot of different viewpoints and people and ways of thinking and living. And that's what makes the world feel so real. And there's always this constant fear of death that we just don't have in our lives anymore. Death is constantly a theme in this show because you see a lot of people die and you really get a feel for it. Like when you see a group of characters get trapped and they get attacked by monsters and you're genuinely thinking like, no, no, God, please don't let them die. I just got attached to these guys. Don't do it. Don't, please. It's just insane how caught up I was in it. Like, I got really emotional watching this show. I cried like 10 times, honest to God. I cry when I'm watching shows that really make me feel something or it's just really cute. I cry over cute things. I really do. And there's a lot of cute things in the show and there's also a lot of pain. And they bring a great balance to each other. And that's what makes it all the more fun to watch. You get more attached to the characters that survive because so many have died before. The characters that do get developed survive barely most of the time. Even when they're like super strong and they're doing really well, they still pull through on the skin of their teeth. And there's always another danger and surprise around the corner. And that's what makes it so interesting because it feels real. Like, they even talk about, after they get out of the game, they even talk about how they had to rehab their bodies because they atrophied over staying in the game for almost like 3 years. It was like 2.5 years. And I was thinking about that the whole time, and they talk about it. So that grounds it in reality. I was so impressed by that because I was like, fuck, you thought of it. You thought of what I was thinking. And I was like, fuck, man, that's insane. The characters in this show are really interesting. You really learn more through their actions rather than their conversations or what they reveal about themselves. Like with Kirito, Kirito travels alone from the very first day of the game. He even makes a friend. He makes a friend on the first day, and even with this friend who wants to stick with him, the guy's a newbie, so he could easily die and die forever. And Kirito's more experienced. Even with him having all of this experience and easily being able to help the guy, he still chooses to leave on his own. He abandons the guy. It was a selfish move, and it was f***ing
interesting. And I was like, that is insane. If it was a shonen anime, he would have stuck with him.
And I just thought that was so interesting of like, why does he travel alone? For one thing, it makes him like a bad character, I know that. But I really think it comes from a sense of insecurity in a way of like low self-worth. And then you have this other character, Asuna, who essentially becomes his girlfriend. They get married and it just touched my heart. I was like, holy crap. I'd never thought of it, but I'd never seen an anime marriage before. This is so cute. Oh my God. And they're getting married because they're in this super brutal world. And so it's like, I care about you. You're really strong and I feel safe around you. Let's be together forever. And I'm like, that's such a good idea! Asuna is such a great character on her own, and I just really wish there had been more of her. She's reduced to this damsel in distress at the end of season one, and it's a shame because she's so strong and she's like interesting, she's tough. She's got balls. It just feels like she was sacrificed for more of Kirito's character development. It's like, I wish Asuna had done more at the end of season one. The whole time that they're like fighting to be together in the real world, Kirito gets freed from the game, but she doesn't. For the whole second half of season one, I was like, please God, let these characters get together. I was like crying on my couch, watching them just like struggle just to be together. And I was like, I am a sucker for romance. Holy crap. This is so awesome. I was like, oh my God, how are they gonna do this? You know, I was like, it was so good. I really liked the first half of season two more than the second half, just because I didn't like Alfheim. There's like a second game that they go to where it's instead of swords and like creatures and everything, it's all elves. I've never been one for Dungeons and Dragons kind of stuff, like, you know, magic and all that. It's just never gotten me. Like, I remember seeing Asuna for the first time and she had a great character design. In the second half of season one, in the elf game, she just has this giant pair of elf ears. And I was like, oh God, what did you do? What happened? No, this poor girl. There's also another villain that's introduced in like the second arc, really. He's kind of well written in a way. He's just kind of an like, honestly. So he creates this elf world, which looks dumb, honestly. And he's like the god of that world, and he wants Asuna to be his bride and all that stuff. It's kind of the same plot from Shrek. But of course, he doesn't get to do that, obviously. They end up together. Thank God. I was so happy when they were finally together in the real world. I was like, dude. I'm kind of hesitant to watch season two because I've heard that it's not that good. So I'm just trying to hold on to how good season one was. But I'll probably watch season two here in a bit. But yeah, I'll see you later.